Hello flight simmers, welcome to the channel and welcome to Stuttgart Airport. This scenery has been sponsored to me by RD Presets, and so I want to take this opportunity to do a flight out of Stuttgart and also showcase this scenery to you a little bit, which is a very nice one indeed. RD Presets, the guys over there have in the meantime come up with a portfolio of pretty cool sceneries scattered all over Europe basically, and this is the latest addition to their portfolio, which is a particularly nice one. We will have a look at the terminal in just a second. I can tell you it's quite stunning. And we are sitting here in the Phoenix A320, of course, featuring a Eurowings livery, however not the standard one you would expect. This one is a rather special one, so throughout the summertime Eurowings is making use of some leased aircraft of a company called, I think it's Avion Express Malta or something like that. And so they haven't fully put their colors on there, just the sort of the lettering on the fuselage, which we can see here. And this livery has been created by Yannick, who is a good friend of this channel. So greetings go out to Yannick at this point, and thank you so much for providing this livery. I will surely make sure to link it down below, and you guys can download it from flightsim.io. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Always kind of cool to fly more like real world ops, since these liveries are actually operating out of Stuttgart these days quite a lot. So this is even closer to reality than just featuring the standard Eurowings livery. So that's pretty cool. Yes, what else to say? Let's proceed over to the terminal. It's really truly stunning. Let's have a look at that. And also, you can probably guess we are flying offline today. I do want to try to fly offline a bit more. The AI traffic is becoming better and better now, also featuring full stars and SID procedures and all this kind of stuff. So yeah, let's see how this works out. Pretty curious about that one. Yeah, and look at this guy. So apron looks absolutely stunning, but that's kind of expected. But when we move inside the terminal area, look at this guy. So that's just mind-blowing. Like, the attention to detail, all the passengers, all these stores up here, McDonald's, of course, has to be there at every airport. And I think over here, the other hall looks just equally nice. Look at this old... Oh, I got no idea what it is. I would be lying putting out a name, but some old military aircraft. Really cool stuff. Although I typically don't spend a lot of time inside the terminals when I do a flight, but this is really kind of fun to check out. We have all the buildings here. We have this very famous parking space. I think maybe it's only sponsored by Bosch, or maybe it's really for Bosch. I don't know. The one of the biggest companies in Germany, and this is a very popular highway passing below this this parking space. So most of the German viewers, I'm quite sure, will know this this building, have passed it at some point in time. So yeah, this is like, this is really immersive, having all this surrounding area here in Stuttgart. That is very cool indeed. Yeah, so cool scenery. We have beautiful weather, very nice summer day here in Stuttgart. And yes, so we will be heading down to Corfu, which also is a very cool airport. The Fly Tampa scenery, which is one of the best scenery developers, as you might know. And the airport itself, Corfu, is also very cool. A very interesting approach, going to be an RNF approach, but we're going to talk about it like 2 hours from now when we get into the approach. But for now, let's set up the departure. Right, here we are. So there's a few things I still need to do, which is load the flight ID over the AOC menu like that. I think we have it on here already. Yeah, that's our flight. Let's go to mass and balance, load aircraft. Let's go fast time, 8 minutes seems about good for us. Then we can head out in due time. Let's do the init on the MCDU, and then Yes, also we kind of started to look at the flight routes and flight plans before we head out. I think that's something that's really appreciated by you guys, so I'm happy to continue that. So let's look at Simbrief. Going down to Corfu, we are actually at max landing weight because we are quite heavy. So 59.2 of zero fuel weight, that's pretty much fully booked. I think I have 170 packs here in the aircraft today. Takeoff weight 68 tons basically, so that's not even so far. That's 5.5 tons away from max takeoff weight. Quite interesting. A part of the reason is alternate is Fiumicino in Rome, and that's a long way. 1 hour and 7 minutes, 2.8 tons of fuel to get us there. But there's good reason for that, which is the weather. Weather these days in Greece, all over Greece, is quite crazy. They have like really strong rain showers, thunderstorms, floodings. So there are thunderstorms all over the area. That's also the reason why I packed 15 minutes of extra fuel, just to give us like this one more approach in case we need it. And Corfu can get busy at times, so also for a potential holding, this is quite useful. And if we look at the weather, we can see, yeah, so Hellas, Sigmet, lots of thunderstorms activity. Let's look at the airports. So here in Stuttgart, it's fine. Variable winds 2 knots. We can depart on runway, I think it's 07. And over in Corfu, so fuel clouds 1,800, broken 3,500, broken 8,000, 28 degrees. And then we have probability 40, low visibility rain, few clouds 1,000 only, towering cumulonimbus. So yeah, it's really not the nicest weather down there. Then on the other hand, Rome is looking pretty good, so that's good. I'm not sure if we have a Sigmet map on here as well. Yeah, there we can see. So coming into Greece, all this area is a weather area of thunderstorms and so on. So that's why the weather here in Stuttgart is much nicer compared to the holiday destinations where we actually want to bring these people to. But yeah, that's what it is. Let's have a quick look at the flight plan. So yes, we're departing runway 07, but we can probably take an initial shortcut here. Don't need to go the sort of the full detour. And then it's just a quick flight down to Corfu, really. It's not super long at all. Okay, so having that established, actually we know our departure already, so I think it's gonna be the Aptal 4 hotel, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, that's the one. Very easy, just out of runway 07, Aptal 4 hotel, 20 miles out, then 15 more to Aptal. So it's just, unfortunately, it's the most boring departure ever in a way, just straight out, but still. It's gonna be scenic with the current conditions. Right, so let's get to it. So we are featuring flight number Eurowings 2618. Call sign is Eurowings 9 Juliet, cost index 15, initial cruise 350, flight plan. Departure 07, Aptal for hotel insert. It's going to be very quick. Arrival, we will plan for the ANAF 34, that's the standard arrival. And the approach is going to be the Tikra to Juliet. We will look at the charts later on, of course. Where is it? Wow, lots of stars. Holy cow. Tikra to Juliet with the Bedeck-Stringerson. Like that. Okay, secondary copy active init wind. Request wind. Right, what else in it? Second page, we have a block fuel of 10.7. Over to Rome takes 2.8, as we have discussed. We have the initial load sheet, which we can put in 59.3 for the zero fuel weight. What else? I think boarding should be completed pretty soon. Yeah, it's not too long. Actually, let's try to be on time here, so we can move ahead and fire up the APU, and then we can get out of here pretty soon. Taxi is gonna be super easy, as you can guess. Just straight out, left and turn, right and turn, and this is the holding point for runway 07. So it couldn't be any shorter than that. Okay, boarding completed. So zero fuel weight 59.4, always rounding up to be conservative. Oh, sorry, that's the wrong one number. Let's try that again. 59.4 and 31.7, like that. Okay, then moving on to the departure. We're gonna have full length. 07, it's dry. Let's go packs on. It is quite warm outside. We don't want the passengers to get a heat shock back there. It is total air temperature, okay, 23 degrees. It's not even that warm, but in the sun, aircraft is heating up quite a bit. Oh, TUI 737 heading out. Nice. Okay, flaps 1 down 01. Down 01 and 153, 53, 54. Flex temperature of 58. It's nice, full D rate. Or I think is 58 in the Airbus? I think it's full D rate for the for this engine type. Not entirely sure. And then for thrust reduction and acceleration, we're gonna feature 20 to 80 engine out, acceleration 2900, and I'm getting this data from the black box 711 airport information page, in case you guys don't know it's a pretty cool one. And then also let's do a fix. The engine out procedure for runway 7 is as follows. So from Stuttgart VOR, I think this is based on, if I'm not mistaken, we gonna head out on track 72 for 20 miles and hold. Yeah. So the blue dotted line, that's our engine out procedure, which is pretty much the same as our departure, really. It's not not a big difference. Right, let's switch on a few things. Constraints, flying offline, so we can go all the way to 350. No worries. Okay, so this is done. Final load sheet coming in. Beautiful, 59.3. That's looking good. Right. Okay, APU bleed, seatbelts. Let's get ready, and then we can run the checklist as well. Okay, so cockpit preparation checklist. Gear pins and covers are removed. Fuel quantity. We have 10.7 tons on board. Seatbelts are on. Adheres. Oh wait, are they? Yeah, they are on. Adheres, IRS monitor, NAF, and NAF. Barrel reference 1021, 1021, 1021. That's checked. Cool. Then also, we don't need a pushback today, which makes it even easier. So this goes to TA. Let's make sure all the ground connections are Yeah, we are on APU power. So this all goes away. Let's GSX know that we don't need a pushback. It should ask for it. Oh no, 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 no. Ah. It's not what I wanted. Usually it's asking. Complete pushback. Oh, okay. Shoot, maybe we need to reset the position in just a second. But no worries. Okay, let's make sure everything is closed up. So, the before start checklist, parking brake is set, takeoff speeds and thrust is inserted, windows are closed on both sides, and beacons are coming on. Before start checklist completed. And now I just need to get rid of GSX. Okay, let's see how I can manage to do that. Okay guys, we're actually doing the pushback now. It makes no sense at all at this stand, but it's easier to complete the pushback than turning off GSX now, so yeah. Ooh, it's quite tight here with the lamppost, but I think GSX got it all figured out. That's good. Yeah, it's still a very short taxi for us, so we're not losing a whole lot of time. Right, let's fire up then, shall we? So, starter coming to on. We are looking for bleed air. And then we can start with engine number 2. Engine number 2 is running. Let's start number 1. Okay, let's look out for traffic. There's one Eurowings taxiing. Not sure if this one is arriving or departing. Okay, pretty cool. I was wondering if he was going to run into us, but he's taking the stand right there. Very good stuff. We have 2 engine starts, so starter back to normal. APU bleeds coming off, APU master coming off, auto brake max, crown spoilers armed, flaps position 1. We set the trim to down 0.1. We do a quick flight control check. Full up, full down, full left, full right, and the rudder full right and full left. That's checked. We will put on the weather radar, predictive wind shears coming to auto, and then we run the after start checklist. Anti-ice not required, ECAM status is checked, pitch trim is set down 0.1, and rudder trim is neutral. After start check is completed. Okay, GSX is gone, so we are good to taxi. Let's move. Oh, I just accidentally hit that switch. Let's put it back to arc. Right. Let's go. Good, yeah, it's a very, very short taxi, so let's give a call to the cabin to let them know that we are about to head off already. Okay, and there's one aircraft on the approach. Okay, strange, I can't see it, although it's not far out. And one Eurowings coming from the other side. Oh, cool. Yeah, let's see how this AI traffic works. Like working with the AI traffic in in P3D is always sort of a pain in the A, but here it's, let's see. Maybe the procedures are much smoother. Okay, let's do the TO config, and then we can run the taxi checklists. Flight controls are checked. Flap settings config 1 plus F, that's once, twice, and three times, that's checked. Radar and predictive wind shear is on and auto. Engine mode selector is normal. EKM mode takeoff, no blue. Taxi checklist completed. Okay, let's see. So that's the holding point. Taxi turn off lights coming off. And let's see. Okay, I still can't see the aircraft. That's a bit odd. Oh, there it is. Really hard to see. And then I'm curious if the other Eurowings is going to taxi on the runway. It probably is. Not sure if it's waiting for us here. Right, but then we should be good to go within the next 3 minutes, I guess.
Traffic.
Yeah, that's checked. Okay, so there was a small private jet, and was. Whatever reason, Eurowings opposite of us has disappeared for whatever magical reason. But so we can taxi on. Oops, strobes coming on. And then let's see. Oh, yeah, he's already vacated. Oh, that was very quick. Very quick indeed. So let's say we are cleared for takeoff. Cleared for takeoff towards Corfu. TARA. Lineup checklist. Takeoff runway. Runway 07 is identified. TCAS is TARA and PEX 1 and 2 are on engines. Lineup checklist completed. Ooh, CRJ coming up, but we are first. Okay, I would say let's keep it rolling. No need to wait up. Timer's running. Power up to 50%. And man flex 58, SRS and runway, auto thrust blue. Climb thrust. some lights. Right, and there's no constraints whatsoever on this departure, so it's really just straight out. These towers look incredibly high. Not sure if this is super realistic. Okay, let's go autopilot. And flaps up. That's interesting. There's another aircraft also climbing TCAS. okay. Traffic in sight. Where the heck is he coming from? Okay, that makes no sense at all. Okay, yeah, that makes very little sense. Okay, maybe AI traffic is also not the very best here in Microsoft Flight Sim. Right, but we are on our way to Corfu, I would say. Everything looking good now. We are climbing, and yeah, there's no after takeoff checklist. So I guess that's it for the departure, and I shall meet you guys for a hopefully nice approach into Corfu. Enjoy! As you can see, and also as we expected, the weather is mediocre at best. Many clouds around. Probably our passengers would have wished to save the money and stay in Germany at this time of the year, having nicer weather over there compared to Greece. But never mind, that's none of our concern. We need to land an aircraft. And so let's brief our plan. We are flying the Tigra to Juliet, although I've made it a bit easy for us and dialed direct at Bedex, which is the initial approach fix. And then we are on the rather famous and popular RNP approach, the RNAV. Yeah, actually it's an RNAV only, it's not an RNP. So RNAV approach into runway 34 at Corfu, which is a very cool approach. So you can see we are coming in from the west, then doing a final 90 degree left hand turn down on the final approach course towards the runway. And there you can also see there's an offset between the final approach course and the runway. And what we will do, we'll just start to descend down here once we're visual and we feel comfortable at switching off the autopilot. Then we will take it manually, make a little bit of a left hand swing to get aligned with the runway. And then, should hopefully be a nice landing. The runway is not huge. The touchdown zone also is pretty short, so there's not a whole lot of room for a long flare. We need to bring it down there. So touchdown rate is not the highest priority here today. But still, I'm hoping for a somewhat decent landing. And then we will vacate Alpha 2. I think there's no chance that we can make Alpha 1. So Alpha 2 will be ours. Also, since the departing traffic is typically waiting on Alpha 1 in order to backtrack and take off onto runway 34. That's usually what's going on down there. Right, for the weather, winds 3 knots, 250, light rain scattered, 1800 broken, 3000 broken, 8000, 23 degrees, 1011. So it's only light rain, it's no gusting winds, it's just a bit of rain, it's no trouble at all really, nothing crazy. I will actually set this down all the way to 1000 since we just continue in LNAV, VNAV mode. Until we get down there. Now we are almost back to profile, which is good, since we are very low. Let's switch those fellows on. Also, let's go to local 1011. We will, what else? Run the approach checklist. Bell reference is set to 1011 three times. Let's check. Seatbelts are on. Minimums are set at 770 for barrow. Auto brake medium and engine mode selector is normal. Regarding the landing calculations, expected landing weight of 65.5, and this will surely be an auto brake medium. I think low is not even enough. Yeah, low we can't do, so it's a medium flip forward, and then we will also use a bit of reverse. Typically on these kind of short runways, heavy landing weight, short turnaround times, that's the most important part. We can't be too hard on the brakes, otherwise the brake too cooldown time gets too long, and then we can't make the return in time. That's typically the biggest consideration for using a reverse thrust upon landing. Right, now the only thing that of course can screw things up for us is the AI traffic, which I hope is playing along nicely today. You can look at the charts for the go-around track, which is at but not before runway 34. Turn right, maximum 185 knot direct to Kilo Romeo 700. Okay. And then all the way back to Baedex holding 4000. Okay, quite easy. So we have NAV and go-around mode enabled. We just need to make sure to fly all the way to the runway and not turn before. Though that's really odd. I wonder why they are not allowed to like make a right and turn somewhere here. But yeah, okay. That's what they are telling us, and that's what we will do for sure. Now, come on, aircraft. Something's odd. Why are we speeding up descending 500 feet per minute? Is it the headwind? Are we... Wow, okay. We were supposed to make 185 knots here. Is that the headwind accelerating us so much? That's already calling for a missed approach, guys, to be honest. That's way too fast. Why are we not slowing down? What am I missing? Is something off with the simulation? Is it a bug, maybe? Final approach. We have speed brakes out. Okay, that's really, really strange. Not quite sure what's going on. What's gear extension speed? Is it... Yeah, it's higher, so let's go gear down. I need all the drag I can find right now.
2000.
Flaps 1, speed checked, flaps 1. Oh, that's gonna be... Ooh, that's a bit of rain down there. Holy cow. Guys, that's gonna be an interesting landing. Flaps 2. Flaps 3. Unfortunately, I wasn't really looking at the navigation display. while that happened, but I really think that was the wind. The wind doing some crazy things there. Okay, 4,000 is set. Now let's see if we can get a visual on the runway. Yeah, okay, there it is. I can see the runway. That's good. Let's do some flying. Flight director's off since we're going off path. Lights are set. Landing checklist. Eco memo landing. No clue. Landing checklist completed. Okay, so I can see the runway, however, there's a big
minima.
Continue. There's quite a bit of rain going on. So there's a slight chance that we lose visual, which I hope is not going to happen. I overshot this turn a little bit.
500.
Okay, 500. Guess we're a little bit late on the steady part.
400. 300.
Okay, 300. Looking good. Now I'm continuing the approach. We're looking good. Just need to make sure to keep bringing it down.
200.
That's the rain. Come on, keep descending.
100. 50. 40. 30. 20. Retard. 5.
And touchdown just in time. Reverse screen decel. Idle forward, manual braking. Haha, ooh. That was fun, guys. That was fun. I think landing was okay. It would have been a bit better when I would have been stable a bit earlier. I think typically we want to be stable at latest 500 feet. Which we have not been, really. But still, worked out okay. Came in a little bit high there over the threshold. Everything seems to work out. Right. Here we are. Welcome to rainy Corfu. Strobes to auto. It's not a long taxi, so we can fire up the APU. Yeah, flight time is not available. During cruise, I accidentally reset at the time, and then I decided to not start it again. Setups here, and there we are. Let's check the touchdown rate. 130 feet per minute. Oh, that's quite good considering the a little bit crazy approach. But yeah, I think we really touched down right on the last touchdown markers. Anything later than that would have been critical. But that's something we can check out on the replay, which I hope worked fine. I have started the recording, so let's see if we can squeeze in a replay. Now we want to find ourselves a stand. 6, 5. I think 5 is quite nice. Which is right here. Perfect. So turn off and taxi lights. And let's park it up. APU available, perfect. Looks like the GSX profile is not perfectly aligned with the center line here. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Wow, right on the mark. Right on the mark. Parking brake. APU bleed, killing the engines like that. Parking brake, fuel pumps, seat belts, nice. Okay, this is coming back to standby. And so the parking checklist, parking brakes and chocks are set, engines are off, wing lights are off, fuel pumps are off, parking check is completed. Now we just need to ask for the boarding. And then we have
the boarding requested.
Made it. So welcome to Corfu once again, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me on this A320 flight from Stuttgart over to Corfu. Two very cool sceneries. We're just seeing a landing back there. Oh, AI traffic. It looks like a gear up landing. Nice job. I think it's another Eurowings. Okay, company aircraft. Yeah, right, so thanks for joining me on this one. I think that was a fun flight, nice approach here into Corfu. Not the most steady approach, I admit that, although the landing worked out to be okay. I haven't seen the replay yet myself, you guys have seen it, so I'm not sure if we were still within the touchdown markers there, but I assume we were, so yeah, I think I'm quite happy with that one, and yeah, I think that's all for this flight. Once again, if you want to find this livery created by Yannick, then feel free to click the link down below in the description. I will make sure to link it there for you guys to pick it up on flightsim.to, and yeah, then you can also leave him a like over there. That would be very cool, since he's a huge supporter of the channel. Very much appreciated to have him on board. So that's that on today's flight. Thank you for tuning in, everyone, and I will catch you on the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.